The real question for Scandal Scar George Newbern, do you sit there with a big vat of popcorn and a huge goblet of red wine and watch all the shows?
I do. I can barely get through it. Right. I passed out on the floor for about 5 minutes. Yeah, it's a good
But people have this great love for your show.
Yeah, yeah. And it's been quite a ride.
Are you a good secret keeper or not?
Terrible.
So what do you do?
Well, people ask me, what's going to happen next? And I give them a little bit, and then I have to literally call ABC. Did I say too much?
Oh, my goodness.
You're fired next day.
Well, you and, on the show, you and Quinn, baby on the way.
Right.
That's
right.
Big.
Yep. She just actually, I believe, had her real-life baby fairly recently, a couple days ago, and everything's great. And, so they're working it into the show, and I don't know how that's going to happen. I'm going to strap on a baby Bjorn and with a drill and rappel some buildings or something.
A question I've asked a couple of your colleagues is that final season, and you know this is all coming. It's, very much announced.
Sure.
So I don't know when, March?
March. We shoot till March, so I don't know when.
Let's make up a date. March 15th.
Sure.
Are you just going to be puddles?
I'm going to be puddles, but I'm very excited because I'm doing a sitcom with ABC called Charlie in Charge. I'm kidding.
Thought
of that this morning.
But to your credit, you are such an accomplished actor. Yeah.
We were in.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
And
yeah. You could have.
Yeah. I'm the landlord of a wayward group of people in inner city Chicago.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Why not?
What?
Here at work on that TV show you've heard of, Scandal. Look.
Olivia Pope and Associates is legend in this town. You trust OPA. Quinn Perkins and Associates? What is that, QPA? It's a babysitting service. Or cupcakes. It's cupcakes delivered by babysitters.
Did you just call me a babysitter?
He's a waste of time. We need to start advertising. Hit the airwaves. Been told my whole life I've got a voice for radio. More of those or switch it up?
Baby's maybe feeling a yogurt. Sorry. David, so help me. You're not leaving until we get a client.
Excuse me? I'm looking for Quinn Perkins and Associates.
Yes. Hello. Oh, thank God. Are you available?
Look at that!
That's
the miracle of that show.
I know.
But there seems to be more so, and you tell me because you've been on tons of projects. A genuine camaraderie with everybody.
Oh, there is. We're every other weekend we have a thing. But someone's having a viewing party.
Oh,
we'll
that's
get
nice.
Together. We're going to go up to Santa Barbara in a couple of weeks. It's going to be great.
Oh, can
really?
We go?
What's
that's for real.
Is it like a retreat?
It's a little wine country thing.
Okay.
It's going to be fun.
There does seem to be a recurring theme.
Yes, absolutely.
I've asked your colleagues about this too. Shonda Rhimes, of course, the creator of this show, announced that big deal with Netflix.
Yep.
What do you think all this stuff, what's happening? What's happening?
I don't know. I wish you could tell me. I think it's great for all the showrunners and creators and stuff. They get more freedom and there's more content than ever. I can't possibly keep up with all the amount of television that's on. So it's great for the creators and whatnot. And I think for the actors and writers, but they're doing less episodes, which is not so awesome for the actors, but more opportunity to do sort of edgier stuff, I guess.
Including the new Charlie in Charge.
Yeah, Charlie in Charge. That's right. Next on Charlie.
Are there these formal table reads where you guys are just like, what?
Yes. We have one Friday. A little sweaty thinking about
really?
It.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? Because you just don't know what's going to happen.
I know I'm not going to die this year. Well, I don't know that, but I mean, I know I've got a contract at the end of the year. So that part I'm not
sure. So that feels good.
Well, you know you're getting paid till the end.
Yeah. My wife and I would come home every week. Did you make it? Yes, I made it. But week to week. But yeah, no, it's exciting. You never know what's going to happen, and they keep spinning the story off in another direction. We just go with it.
All right. Most important thing in George's entire life is, I'm not giving too much away, but that big Century City Mall is opening.
Oh.
You're in spitting distance of Italy.
Oh, cannot wait.
Do you think you'll just go daily?
I'm gonna run for an hour and a half every day so that I can go to Italy.
Perfect.
4 days a week.
That's great.
Absolutely.
Have you been to the one in New York?
Yes, the one in New York and Chicago.
Right.
So.
Oh,
see? Fantastic.
You beat us all. Scandal 7, season 7 premiere. What are you doing today? Are you live tweeting or what's
happening? We have a little, like right down the street, a little 4-hour live tweet thing at Sunset Gower. I don't know what's going to happen. But
I know he's competitive. Is Josh Molina the best tweeter?
Yes. Well, he's the meanest, that's for sure. Jeff Perry's quite good. Jeff Perry preloads all of his tweets.
Oh, that's cheating.
No, it's not cheating.
I think that is cheating.
I can't watch an episode and tweet at the same time.
Right.
I don't have that.
Preload, huh?
I don't have that.
Preload. Like,
preload.
Wow, can you believe that?
Well, he knows a couple of moments and he goes, and then it happens, he goes, boom.
That's
what you gotta do. That's the key to that.
That's
being prepared.
You know what? That's the scandal.
It's in the drafts section of Twitter.
Really?
So
okay.
You know that. Yeah.
He preloads. That's terrible. George, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Thank you.
Wow. Thanks. Awful.